Jamaica is universally known for its top track athletes. But the 2011 World University Games brought a new name and another discipline into the spotlight. The name is O'Dane Richards. He's 24 years old, and his passion is to throw things.
Actually, a moment when you throw and the implement starts to get small as it goes away from you, and that moment you know that you have done really well, all the training has come together. So that's what I like about the sport.
Through high school and college, O'Dane was a devotee of the discus and the shot put. But like most of the Jamaican students, his first goal was to get a good education.
From St. George's College, I wanted to do the animation, but it didn't offer it, so it was a computing school. So I thought that I could use this as a stepping stone to go to the next level. When I started UTEC in 2007, I had not thrown the senior weight. So I started about probably 15 meters. And then I didn't have a steady coach. So this was where I first met Mr. Swaby. And he was trained to do the throws because he was also a thrower himself. He was also coached by Stephen Francis. So I started to get the coaching aspect of it, the more technical details of the sport. And I realized it as I did that, my distances started to improve.
Linval Swaby is the throwing coach of the MVP Track and Field Club, an assistant at the University of Technology in Kingston. He saw the talent of O'Dane.
His technique was okay compared to the other guys because he actually did the rotation from in high school, and most of the other guys in high school did the glide. So, you know, I was fascinated by it. He seemed compact, that was one. You know, I saw him and I realized that, you know, with a few minor adjustments, you know, him could be a better thrower. So I started pursuing, you know, him to come in here, you know.
But like most student athletes, the challenge for O'Dane Richards was to perform at the top level in both sport and academic study.
At UTEC, education is first. We try to, you know, implore upon the athletes, the students, to actually try to graduate because, you know, after the sport, you know, you need a life. So I saw him first as a student, but an athlete is right as close to it because I would like him to be a professional athlete, but I would like him to also have his qualifications.
Sport gave O'Dane a certain discipline, but the education system definitely helped to structure him to become a complete athlete.
It was extremely demanding. It pressured you to keep focus on what you were about, you know. You had to get the grades, and you wanted to do well at the athletics, so it was really demanding. Sleepless nights. There was one time where I had to stay on campus and study right through the night just to get the grades.
After his arrival at UTEC in 2009, the young thrower improved all his marks and became the Universiade champion in 2011, a competition that gave him the motivation to go on to break his own personal records.
If it wasn't for the World University Games, I didn't think I'd have thrown 19.9 that year. I don't think that I would have pushed myself. I'd probably go to a meet in the area in the Caribbean, but the competition level is not that high. And because of what FISU has done, it gave me an opportunity to rub shoulder to shoulder with some of the big names in the sport. Like Mart Israel, he threw in the discus. Mason Finley, he threw in the shot. He's a big number one in the US. So without FISU, I don't think it would have given me the impact that I have today.
The University Games gave him the boost he needed to keep improving, out to 2 meters 31 in the shot put.
it gave me a look into the future, where I believe that some of those guys that competed at the World University Games would be future Olympians. So if I could get the best of them at World University Games, maybe it would translate into getting a gold medal at the Olympics, World Championships, or any other meet that matters.
So this July in Kazan, the Jamaican will be there to defend his title at the World University Games on the road to that potential Olympic medal. Jamaica has a population of less than 3 million, but there are 45,000 students in the island's university and college system. It's a system generally based on British education. Intercol is the governing body with the job of developing and promoting the strength of university sport.
We recognize that we have some very talented student athletes here in Jamaica, and we can put together a championships that can hone these skills, that can develop these skills, that can build them to the national level. And we think, especially in track and field, a lot of our athletes do better who stay home. So we believe that there's a system here that can help to develop those talents.
Following the detection work made in high school, the prestigious University of Technology of Jamaica offers educational programs leading to a career in sport.
We've been particularly careful to ensure these students get mentoring, okay? And we follow them to ensure that they are following up on their academic programs, and where they have difficulties, we see how best we can assist them. What we have done at UTEC in particular is to facilitate by a flexibility of programming. The usual 3 year could easily be extended to 4 or 5 years, and allowing them to accumulate or bank their credits towards acquiring their degree, and allowing them the chance to maximize their sporting potential. But when some of our student athletes are, for example, on retreat or training, for example, in Australia, they will submit their assignments via email and the technology support.
Among the 12,000 students at UTEC, 400 follow one of the sports programs.
Sport, as it's and of itself, is a tremendous trainer for self-discipline, time management, and you learn what it means to go that extra mile. We have in our midst a number of students who have excelled in terms of the academics.
The island's two big institutions, UTEC and the University of the West Indies, have provided some of the best athletes of all time, and the University Games have brought that talent to light.
World University Games 2 years ago did something magnificent for us as a country. We sent, I think it was 12 athletes and got 9 medals, and those medals helped to push and propel our track and field program in Jamaica a bit more. Say for Odane Richards was one of those guys, and he got the gold in the shot put. Hansa Parchment later went to the Olympics and copped a bronze medal in the 110 hurdles. He won the 110 hurdles at the World University Games. We'd want to send a lot more athletes, but we're in a situation of financial challenges within the entire world, and certainly here also, so we won't be able to send them, you know, the great amount that we want. But over a period of time, probably the next 2 years and 4 years' time, we'll be able to send a very large contingent who will be doing well.
With a proven system in place and a new generation of athletes, we'll no doubt see more Jamaican success at the forthcoming Universiade. In part two of Campus, how FISU has pioneered sports like women's ski jumping, basketball 3-on-3, and rugby sevens. Stay with us.